Hey everybody, this is JTB.
And this is Bigowski.
And we're back for Chapter 2 of the Hurricane Pack 1 Karma Run for Ninja Gaiden 2004. So the last video was really short, we didn't have a whole lot of time to explain stuff. Going into this fight, this is a really good showcase of the intercept trick. So you want to make sure you save that torch, we didn't actually mention that in Chapter 1, but don't break that in that fight, it is easily done if you're not careful. You really want to roll forward and charge for this. Now, one thing that's important to note, if you're not too familiar, you might not notice it, but by default, you actually have celerity UT charge times in Hurricane Pack 1. As far as I recall, the armlet of celerity is not in this, is it? Can you remember?
No, I don't believe it is.
Yeah, but if you actually pay attention to the charge times, they are actually as fast as having armlet of celerity, and they're even faster off of an intercept, so that's really, really helpful for actually getting your UTs out. You don't have to be as defensive. But the downside, of course, to it is you have to be more precise with your timing because you don't actually have as long to wait and delay to actually charge up ultimate techniques. So, you know, if you want an ET, for example, you can usually charge an ET pretty slowly, whereas in here you'll charge one, you know, very, very quickly. So your timing needs to be, you know, adjusted to take into account that.
Boy,
so, yeah, this is pretty much just, you know, farm the sky.
Right. I'm telling you, this was known back then. And you know, here's something else. You got to hand it to the guy who got the top score on the leaderboard because he really didn't know everything that we know today. I mean, I made my videos and uploaded them back in April of 2010. I mean, that's how long ago this been. So the guys who got the top scores back then and really understood it without having the benefit of Iberian site whenever it was up, you know, kudos to those guys.
Yeah, definitely. And a lot of things as well, it really brings into account how much this is about speed. You'll see it in a few fights, but like that fight right there, it's not viable at all to farm intercepts because the samurais attack you so slowly. And the main way you kind of figure that out, it is a lot of maths really, that it's pretty straightforward to work it out, but you do the same formula of you work out your kills and points by your seconds and the total, you know, possible extra kill bonus. And if you have enemies that can attack you really quickly and your seconds are worth less than 1,000 points, then in those fights you want to figure out, you know, the most optimal way to farm intercepts because, you know, if you're killing everybody with, say, you know, half the time left on the clock, but you're only getting, say, 10,000 points extra kill bonus, but you could farm, you know, 25 intercepts, you know, the intercepts are worth more points than farming, going for that speed kill. Same principle here, the samurais, if they attacked you quicker, I would farm them here because you actually have quite a lot of time, but they don't. So, you know, ETs are the best way to kill them quickly.
Go ahead and explain a little bit more about the intercept and how you do it versus blocking.
That's a good thing to explain. I mentioned it briefly in the other video. Your mileage will vary on how easy you find it to do. You'll never get it every single time. I mean, I missed one right there. But you do it just before the enemy hits you. The window for it is extremely large, in my opinion. People may disagree on that. It reminds me a lot of the deflect critical system in the Onimusha games. Anyone that's played those will kind of be able to draw a comparison there. And the timing on that is extremely strict. If you're off by even a second, like a split second, it won't work. Whereas for the intercept, it's really quite liberal, the timing. You just kind of have to just tap block before they hit you. You know, it doesn't have to be a split second before. Another similar system to it is the Royal Guard style in Devil May Cry 3. That is extremely precise, whereas this isn't. You know, it's really quite easy to do. The main thing that factors into it is how well do you know the enemies, because a lot of the attacks in the game, the enemies will do certain attacks depending on the distance they are away from you, what attack they are doing, what state they're in. That really is where it falls into your control because, like, for example, the ninjas, by doing the shuriken staggering, I know that just because of the way their AI works, that eliminates their grab from their attack pattern. They will never do it. If you don't know that, you won't be able to do that and get the maximum amount of intercepts. So while the execution of doing it is definitely really important, the knowledge of the enemies is really what you need to actually get the intercepts you need out of the fight.
Plus, it's a lot of fun.
It is real fun to intercept. One of the things I love doing, you might have noticed it on some of these intercepts. If you actually you get an intercept like one, I love it when there you do three so quickly you actually see like a 3,000 intercept bonus pop up. that I think that just looks so cool. I love the noise it makes. I think the visual effect of it is really cool. It is a lot of fun to just intercept everything. And on that subject, I think I might have mentioned this in the earlier video. As you can see here, I can intercept the fireballs. They actually guard crush you normally. As long as the attack isn't unblockable or a grapple, you can intercept it. So even if an attack guard crushes you, if you intercept it, it will do zero guard damage, and you'll be able to intercept it and get the benefits of an intercept.
See,
like
and
that right there, I love that.
Well, you know, in Ninja Gaiden Black, you'd like shoot these guys from an arrow, you know, with an arrow to just kill them. But here, since you want the intercept, you know, you run towards them, and hey, if they shoot at you, even better.
I like that ending too. Like,
oh yeah, that was awesome. Like, that was awesome.
Oh, by the way, people will realize it on the kill system. Usually, you'd kill Masakado quickly. He doesn't count as a boss, as you can tell there. He doesn't have 100,000 points, which is why you want to, you know, go for the intercepts and kill all the mages in Hurricane Pack 1.
And also to get your interchapter kills.
Exactly. Yeah. So that's it for Chapter 2, guys. So if you enjoyed it, the next videos will actually get longer. I leave in more traversal stuff, so you have more time to chat. So until then, we'll see you next time.
Thanks. We'll see you guys.